You are looking at the golf course that will be hosting the Barbasol event coming up here in July at Champions at Keene Trace. That is a live look. So we got some folks getting ready to take a shot around the water hazard out there. Some sunshine has reemerged after storms earlier this afternoon. So again, that's a look we'll be giving you a lot of. Just the beautiful grounds over there at the Champions at Keene Trace that get set for the Barbasol FedEx Cup event. All righty. Storms were around earlier today for many of us. Some of us still seeing some if you're in eastern, southeastern parts of Kentucky. With the storms that you're seeing out there, heavy rain, lightning, which has been really a big part of a lot of these storms. So as we've gone through the last 4 hours or so, watch how they came across the I-75 corridor again. Heavy downpours associated with it, and then they congealed into some pretty big storms going through eastern Kentucky. A lot of rain with those. More storms up here in, you know, southern Indiana, southern part of Ohio. Those will clip northern Kentucky. More west of I-65 and more still back toward western Kentucky and southern Illinois. So the motion on these, you see that initial batch going through our area on more or less due east course. But these ones out along I-65, they've got a little bit more of a northwest or northeasterly bend. And the ones coming back through the Wabash Valley are a little more of a southeast. So you can make a case, a little bit of a trough sitting right in there. We do have flood watches, but well to our west. In fact, just west of Louisville. And the flood advisory, northern Morgan County and Elliott County. So heavy rain has been a calling card for many of these. We'll be tracking more of them later on. A lot of lightning again with the storms coming in later on tonight, tomorrow. Another day with storms in the area. Not an all-day rain. Today hasn't been all-day rain. Neither will tomorrow be. You'll get a line that comes through. You may get some heavy rain with that. And once those go by, we're going to watch a heat ridge develop. Now, what it means for you at first is we're going to cut the humidity, which seems kind of counterintuitive when you're talking about the building heat, but it'll be heat without humidity at first, and then the mugginess will follow. And the variability on these thunderstorms. Boy, you get under one, you can get a lot of water. Look at Mount Sterling in London. Better than 2 inches of rain, but then some of the neighbors nearby, not nearly so much. So kind of the hit and miss variety of these thunderstorms. Temperatures, we are a little bit below the normal, not by much, a degree or so today. We've been in the low 80s, maybe getting a degree above tomorrow. Look at the heat building, though, as we head towards Saturday and Sunday with 90s looming. 79 at the Bluegrass Airport, 0.2 inches of rain so far, and that dew point at 70. That means it is really muggy out there. And where the rain has not been, temperatures are running in the mid-80s. Where the rain has been, we're in the low and mid-70s. And again, those dew point numbers are sticky. It is really oppressive west of I-75. As we are continuing ahead here, when you're looking at the dew point numbers off the future track, what we're looking at here as we go through the day tomorrow, it's going to be another humid day. But we roll past tomorrow into Thursday. Oh, when those numbers head down into the 50s, you walk outside and it just feels good. A lot more comfortable air. It'll still be warm, but just not humid. So another batch of storms comes through later on tonight. When the cold front arrives tomorrow, it will bring with it one more batch of storms. Then the cold front goes through, high pressure builds in, and our weather turns good. Mostly cloudy, muggy, scattered thunderstorms. Some locally heavy rain later on tonight, down to around 70. Tomorrow it's mid-80s. Partly to mostly cloudy and muggy day with scattered thunderstorms. But by Thursday, the storms are headed out. We're in the low 80s. Friday, hot but not humid, close to 90. The humidity will build over the Father's Day weekend with highs in the 90s.
A seriously good-looking stretch of weather for Father's Day weekend.
Into it and beyond. That's how we plan it. Yeah. You know, when you got a little the knobs and dials back here, we can arrange things.
I like that. Yeah. Thank you.
All right.